Hello everyone, my name is Amadeus Frazier. You can hear me from all the way over there, right? I have a mic. Pretty cool, right? Thanks to my videographer for that. But again, I'm Amadeus Frazier. I'm at my university today, the business school, King's University, and I want to tell you why I am motivated by money. Alright, hello everyone. Amadeus Frazier here, checking in at the King's University Business School. And I want to talk to you about a pretty touchy topic, but it's pretty truthful. You know, people are motivated by this thing called money. And I'm gonna quickly tell you why I'm motivated by it personally. And it's basically because of my upbringing. I didn't grow up in the greatest background. I don't want to get into that. I don't want to wait crying on the computer screens or the tablets, whatever, have you watching this. I don't want you crying, so I'm not gonna get into my background. But I didn't come from the wealthiest background, guys. And I was blessed, I use the term blessed, I was blessed to get a scholarship to a boarding school in Wisconsin, which is near Chicago, United States. I was blessed to be having able to go to Japan, live with 6 different host families, and I was blessed to have come here to the UK and basically see all these different peoples. Now, the reason why I say I was blessed, because one, I believe I was blessed, but the reason those are very key things to outline is because I've literally seen the level of money at every single stage. Again, my upbringing, for I guess the first 13 years when I didn't go to boarding school, I thought the level of money I had was normal. But then I went to boarding school, and that changed like that. You know, I started to see how people acted with their money, how they spent their money differently from what I was used to. And I've been with people who has a lot of money, who have a lot of disposable income. I've been with people who have fairly little, or a lot, all in my boarding school. I've seen all that, right? And you have to think about this. I was in school, I was exposed to all this, and then I would come back home where it wasn't, when money was pretty scarce. So you see where the kind of the conflict kind of started in my head. So not only that, after I go to boarding school for 3 years, graduated early, I go to Japan for a year. And I live with 6 different host families. And all 6 had different levels of income. I'm not gonna go in depth, but I did have one and I was living fairly okay. And I had one, guys, the manager, like he was a manager at McDonald's. Like McDonald's, you know. I think I know that person. I'm in my university. I think I saw someone that I knew. But one of my host dads was the manager at McDonald's, so he had excess money. And I was seeing that. And again, then I would come back home at the end of the year and I would look at myself and look at my family. I was like, wow. It changes having a lot of money, not having a lot of money. So then I came to this conclusion of why I'm motivated by money. And guys, I'm gonna explain to you this later on, but I'm motivated by money because of the opportunity it can bring. See, don't think someone is evil because when they say they're motivated by money, let's walk up here. I wanna walk up here. Yeah. Just because someone says they're motivated by money doesn't necessarily mean they're evil. It's the association with money that makes them evil. If someone says they are motivated by money because it gives them power, you have to actually examine that person. If someone says they're motivated by money because it gives them status, you might have to watch out for that person. If someone is motivated by money because they say it gives them the opportunity to share and to give to people, give to charities and whatnot, and it goes on and on. For me, I'm motivated because of the opportunity it brings. You know, when I was in Japan, you know, I had to take an SAT to get here, to get to the UK. And one thing I realized was that one of my tests was in Okinawa, Japan. It was in another, so to say, part of Japan. I actually had to take a plane there. And luckily enough, I had the opportunity to actually take the plane from Osaka to Okinawa. You know, that's not something you can do with not a lot of disposable income. So I was able to see, okay, with more money, you're actually able to give more opportunities to people, give more opportunities for myself, more opportunities to my family. And that's how I see it. I make money. I'm going back to New York next week. I'm taking my mom out for a whole day. We're going to go out wherever. We haven't decided yet. We're going to go out. You know, I wasn't able to do that without money. You can't do that. You can't have people help you out. I always say, if someone's going to help me out with something, I have to pay them because I respect time. I can pay them. I have the opportunity to pay them. I'm going to pay them. And I think that's what money can do for you. So it's the opportunity that it brings. It's not necessarily the status of money or anything else. That's different. So again, guys, being motivated by money is not evil, because money is just a piece of paper. You can dispose of it, you know. And people say time is money. Not necessarily, because if you had $100 bills or 100 pounds bills, you can burn it. You know, but you can't burn. If you take a second and waste it, you can't get that back. But you can get back 100 pounds. So time, for me, brings opportunity. That didn't really make any sense. That was for another video. I was thinking ahead about my other video. I'm going to use that term. But anyways, let me just wrap up here because I don't want to roll in for too long. Again, I'm in my business school. And I hear this a lot, how business school teaches students how to be evil. And one thing about being evil is making money. Guys, making money is not evil. It's your association with money that's going to determine whether you become evil or not. And like I said, I am motivated by giving opportunities to people. And that goes within my five principles of abundance: dream, initiative, knowledge, progress, and opportunities. So if you haven't watched that video, you can go and watch that video. It's called Why You Should Be an Entrepreneur, or Five Principles of Abundance. And I say, in order to be your abundant self, you have to be able to give people opportunities to better themselves. And that goes without saying. So, guys, I'm Amadeus Frazier checking out. Today, I just debunked two theories, man. Why business is not evil, and why I'm motivated by money. And how it's not, how that is not necessarily evil. There's people walking up and down the stairs, so yeah, so we're going to walk back here. Yes, again, I'm going to sign out here. I'm Amadeus Frazier at the business school, King's University. And guys, hopefully that added value to you. Hopefully you learned something from there. Not just from me, but from yourself and how you, sorry about that, people behind you. It's Saturday, like not a lot of people's in the uni today. And it's mad nice. But anyway, yeah, hopefully this added some type of value to you, and you can probably understand what's your association with money. Because once you figure out your association with it, then that's gonna determine why you actually really want to make money. Everyone's motivated to make money to an extent, but it's why you want to do it. So guys, again, hope I added value. I said that three times. I'm signing out. And yeah, from the business school, King's University. Beautiful day in London. So I'm gonna sign out here, guys. Peace out.